who are we? We're a super team. We're super great and we're not mean. We love soup and we love steam. Watch us make a broth, our smiles beam. It's a special connection from you to me. Lowertown cooks and Lowertown cleans. Lowertown does everything just you see.
Just you see.
I love you, you will know.
You will know.
This is Lowertown Cooking Show.
Yeah, it is. It's the cooking show.
What's up? Lowertown in the building. We're about to make salmon. Salmon, potatoes. I don't know where those are though. First step is boiling potatoes. Olivia is the master chef, but she said that I could boil the potatoes, so I feel pretty special.
Yeah, you're gonna have to wait there for like
5 minutes until it boils, but I'll show you when it boils. It'll go boom. So right now I'm cutting this, I would say it's about a fourth and a half of this onion. And the trick is always to hold it by the blade. So you go like that, and then okay, maybe more like that. Kabloom, 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 kabloom. See, you gotta go like this so it doesn't cut your fingies. See how my fingers are still there?
You said you gotta do like really fast. So you boil
really
your hands. That's how you do it. It's a quick draw. Okay, that's enough.
Wait, it's gonna boil over.
It's basically over.
Right now I'm draining. My hands are getting shaky. That's how you do it right there. That's how it's done. Now check this out. But only a little bit though, so we can just put an extra Did I take out too much water?
That's probably fine.
Okay. Should I put more water in it?
That's fine.
Okay.
That's fine.
Just put it out of me.
Sauteing vegetables. You must chop up the garlic really small because you don't want big chunks of garlic when you eat it. And then you chop up the onions a little bit bigger, but not too big. And then you cut up the mushrooms a little bit bigger because you want some chunks of mushrooms. And then you put the spinach in very last, because if you put it in at the same time as all the other vegetables, they wilt and it just shrivels into nothingness.
I'm patting down the salmon with this paper towel. Look at it, it's so dry. You gotta be really polite to it. You gotta be like, here you go. You give it a little wrap. Not on my face, obviously, because that'd be gross. It's got salmon juice on it.
I put garlic powder, garlic granules, and onion granules, and actual chopped garlic, actual chopped onion, and butter. I like adding onion powder and garlic powder just because it adds a little bit more oomph to it. When onions get cooked, like if you cook them in oil and stuff and you leave them to sit a little bit, it'll get like a crisp, like a brown crisp around the edges. We don't have that quite yet. And also it gets translucent. It's still pretty opaque, so we're gonna wait a little bit. Cause I'm not trying to cook it on a high heat quite yet, cause I want the rest of this onion to cook with it. But I'm just cooking it as I'm going along. So I put lemon on first because usually when I put lemon on last, it makes all the spices go off. But what I'm gonna do is no more garlic in here.
So what do I do with the garlic?
I'm gonna put it on here. So I'm doing lemon juice first, and then I do salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, chopped garlic, and then I'm gonna put some rosemary, and then maybe a little bit of like lemon pulp if I'm feeling crazy.
I put garlic in the veggies and not on the fish, and then I didn't mince it up. Mincing is when you cut it up really, really tiny. So this is not minced, this is raw garlic. And then I cut it up too big, and Olivia was like, no. And then I cut it up right, and I put it in the veggies, and Olivia was like, no. I mean, it's my mistake, but you know.
as putting some chopped slash minced garlic on these salmon. It's really good when it's cooked. It really brings out the flavor. And then I'm gonna put some lemon pulp on it and some rosemary, and these potatoes are boiling over.
I'm hungry. So what I'm doing right now is mashing potatoes. I've got milk at the bottom, and I've got some butter in here too to make it easier for me to mash. So I'm taking this fork, because we don't have like a big boy masher, and I'm just stabbing it a bunch of times until it gets softer, and then I'm gonna go like this with the back of the fork and kind of work it, you know? And then, see, it just, just gonna stab it a bunch. Well, I'm working it. I guess that's all I'm good for, huh? All I'm doing is working potatoes. Olivia's getting to season the salmon, and she's getting to make the taste good. And what do I take the fork and I go, whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. That's all I am.
You're valuable to us.
No, I'm not valuable. I'm expendable. If I died right now, you should just get a different potato masher. So what I'm doing right now is I'm salting these potatoes, because potatoes are bad without salt. And I'm gonna do salt and pepper.
I just put the salmon in the oven. I'm cooking it for about 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna check on it, because the fillets are very thin, so they may get overcooked really easily. This is almost done. It just needs to be mashed a little bit more. And then that's almost done, and it's like 5 more minutes.
So now we're checking on the readiness of the salmon. We gotta see if it's pink or purple.
Looks ready.
Looks ready. It's grubbing time. Yeah, I'll take it off.
Well, I think it went pretty well. We don't have a bake option on the oven, so we had to use broil the whole time. Some of the lemon and the garlic got a little too burnt, but I think you can just scrape that off. I think it just gave it a good flavor when you cook the salmon with it on top of it. But the front two pieces look really nice. I think it looks really moist and not overcooked, not undercooked. I think it's a nice, perfect cook. I'm really excited for the garlic mashed potatoes. I'm really excited for the sauteed vegetables. It's a nice, wholesome family meal. Thank you so much for watching.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.